All right, so fulgurite is on my card. I highly suggest you turn up the volume and get extra focused on what I'm about to show you. Why is fulgurite cool? A lot of stones, they take tens, thousands, millions of years to grow in Earth. This is done by a strike of lightning on sand. My first impressions of fulgurite, probably not gonna be a cut gem, not gonna be polished, gonna be rough, probably kind of a grayish brown color. I've heard of fulgurite before, but let's jump in to what is in this box. Fulgurite. Kind of what I expected. So what I'm seeing right now is it almost looks hollow. You can't, oh, I can see straight through the stone. Kind of a tube, sharp, reminds me of like a sea anemone almost. How far can I get my finger in this? Not too far. It's really rough. I'm afraid I'm gonna like rip some of this off, but I don't think it's that delicate. So what is going on inside of this? It's kind of slimy, very smooth in the inside. It almost looks like moss or like spider webs, but there's not many moss or spider webs. It's just kind of the structure and the way the molecules fuse together. That'd be where the lightning went through? I don't know, guys, I just don't know. It's almost like a bluish gray, like there's a cat breed. It's like the blue, I think you guys know what I'm talking about. Russian blue cat. I'm a crazy cat lady. So we're gonna move on to talking about gemstones. So my normal person brain, not a gemologist, thinks this is pretty cool. I mean, look at the color, the way it's made. Not too heavy, but this really makes my gemology brain go crazy because this is not a structure that we see often. I don't care how many gemstones you've seen, I don't care how many specimens you've seen, this is pretty darn cool. All right, so in Earth, we have three elements that make up most of Earth, and that is aluminum, Al, silicon, Si, and oxygen, O. What is interesting about this is that it's made up of silicon and oxygen because of the quartz-rich sand. So that's only two of the most commonly found elements in Earth, but a lot of times there's gonna be different minerals, different types of rocks, and that is why you have these different types of colors in fulgurite. So it's all these different chemicals and minerals coming together heated by the lightning. What's interesting, what people actually talk about with fulgurite, complex tubes, no two are gonna look alike. It's almost like a fingerprint. I would love for you all to be able to take a look at this up close. That's all I have for you today. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Send your comments to me below. Tell me if something you've seen that's cooler than fulgurite.